Welcome. My name is Ara Eckel, and I'm the Director of Product Management for ClearSky Smart Fleet and the development team at JLG. Thank you so much for tuning in for this launch demonstration and presentation of the all-new ClearSky Smart Fleet. Soon to be standard on most JLG equipment, we are providing the capability to connect beacon with feature-rich content, delivering you more cost-effective solutions that maximize ROI. As opposed to others providing a single piece of software, ClearSky Smart Fleet was built from the ground up as a robust platform. The industry's next frontier in streamlined communication and efficiency is at a thumb's reach, all due to JLG's exclusive ClearSky Smart Fleet IoT solution. This groundbreaking technology was developed by JLG in-house for our customers, housing as many as 25 distinct applications between analyzers, telematics, productivity applications, all housed within one singular connectivity beacon. Let's get into how this works by demonstrating the ClearSky Smart Fleet mobile application. The first step you'll do is log in using your Online Express credentials, which is going to give you access to the scale of Online Express as it's integrated to manage your fleet, increase productivity and features, as well as purchase parts. Once you've logged into the mobile application, you'll realize very quickly that this was built from the ground up. It's not just another version of a singular web portal turned into a mobile app. We all know how difficult it can be to find a JLG asset, either on a job site or on the branch location, and we've made that available for what used to take minutes, now available at the speed of light. First feature we're gonna highlight for you is Find My Machine. In this case, I've arrived on the job site and I'm looking for a specific asset being the E300, and I have the ability to not only swipe, but I can do what's called detect, which will give us both audio and visual cues as we connect to that connectivity beacon. Finding the machine is only the start of what you can do with the mobile application. In addition to that, you can get status indication, use the light or horn capabilities, and get a ton of quick access information available right at your fingertips. Let's start by taking a look at the fleet view, where it's showing that I'm highlighted to one machine as the paired one via Bluetooth, which is leveraging our Bluetooth mesh network. In addition to that, you'll get real-time active data, in this case like the 670SJ, which just went from ignition off to ignition on status. Now, one of the nice parts about using Bluetooth or Wi-Fi capability is we're not leveraging cellular for many of the things that we're doing. Knowing that many of our job sites don't have cellular connectivity, you can now still interact with your machines as a tech or a fuel truck driver arriving on that job site. So on the top, I can click on the search bar and I could search for a boom specifically, or I could search for that 670 specifically as well, or you could even search by serial number. It's up to you and your convenience. In the top right-hand corner of the screen, you click on the applicable filters, and this could apply any filter that we have to the fleet view to filter your selections out. If it's easier for you, we also have these quick access cards. By hitting them, it will actually filter your insights. In this case, I clicked on ready, but any one of the cards, if you were to push and hold, can also give you programmable or customizable filters, again, to gain additional insights to your fleet. So let's imagine we were the service tech who arrived on this job site, and we were told to fix all the machines with active DTCs. Just by clicking DTC and then turning status indication on, you can see for all the ones that are blinking red, they have active DTCs, and all the ones that are green are good to go, therefore better prioritizing my time and making me more efficient. Additionally, you could think about this as the fuel truck driver. Maybe I arrived on the job site and I was told that I had to fuel up the telehandler, but while I'm here, the yellow status indication on the RT2669 is making me aware I could probably refuel that today and maximize my time and value. As the world of electrification continues to grow in importance, we're offering new insight on electric products as well. So here, you can also see information such as state of charge. In this case, the ERT is going to need to be plugged in to receive a better state of charge. And why that E300 is receiving such a good state of charge is if we use the charging filter, you'll actually see based on the teal icon, it's plugged in the wall and actively receiving voltage, leading to its positive state of charge that it has now. Last but not least, if you put yourself in the branch manager's shoes, we also have a feature called Near Me. Near Me would say if you had multiple machines in a row and I just wanted to pick out a specific serial number, I could turn on the status indication light and just by the beacon light color, mash up with my fleet view, I could dive into one asset specifically to gain all that insight without ever leaving the comfort of my office or my desk. Now that we've gone over fleet level views and quick access cards, I'm gonna deselect the Near Me card, and now we're back to our original fleet level view. At this point, we're going to dive deeper into an asset view, but specifically the built-in Bluetooth analyzer functionality. Today, you might think about using our handheld analyzer, and now we've integrated that functionality via Bluetooth. At which point, I'm going to click into our 670 SJ. First thing you'll see is that temporarily the analyzer tab is grayed out, as it identifies that that's in a machine on state, same way you'd have to use that handheld analyzer today. We've now confirmed that this is available for use. By clicking on the analyzer tab as the user, it's going to confirm that I'm drawing the relationship with that machine and that I can use the functionality to set up personalities or receive other types of information, same way you do today. By clicking confirm, it's going to take my parent relationship from a Bluetooth machine that was elsewhere and make this the specific asset I'm paired to. Now I know I'm actually controlling the machine personalities and functionality of that asset. And as you'll notice, this is the same exact user interface and experience that people have in the handheld analyzer today, making it an easier transition from the physical to the digital world. Now that we've walked through the digital analyzer, it's important to think about how we can troubleshoot machines on site and better service them. In this case, you can get quick access to information like diagnostic trouble codes. In addition to that, you can leverage the scale of Online Express by going to knowledge articles to keep your machines running like never before. Last but not least is digital access control. We know that safety of the equipment, the operators, and general job site safety is paramount. That's why we've had the ability to limit unauthorized utilization of your specific asset using the tab called Machine Restrictions. At this point, I'll click on Machine Restrictions and you can see four machine states. If I were to change the specific restriction, as an example, from unrestricted to a lockout state simply by clicking on that, it's gonna pop up a warning making me aware that I am now manipulating that machine specifically and that I'm taking on ownership of that shift in that machine personality. And as I click confirm, you'll see that that state has actively changed. So those are the launch features of the ClearSky Smart Fleet mobile application. At this time, we're gonna transition to the Online Express portal of ClearSky Smart Fleet, where you can gain more actionable insights about your fleet. Integrated into Online Express, the ClearSky Smart Fleet web portal delivers robust, data-driven insights that is customizable to the user. Working in tandem with our mobile application, JLG has the ability to provide customers more actionable insights about their product than any other provider, period. Let's dive in. We've automated the process for subscribing to ClearSky Smart Fleet. By simply going to the Online Express portal in the subscription tab, in less than four clicks, you'll have the ability to view fleet-driven insights like never before. Let's go through that process now. By clicking on the subscription tab, you'll be dropped into a ready to get started page, at which point by clicking getting started, you'll get unlimited access to the portal and application. In addition to that, you can click the selectable API data feed add-on, at which point you can agree to terms and conditions by checking the box. And last but not least, you'll be able to see your confirmation of your ClearSky Smart Fleet purchase invoice. And by checking the box, you have the ability to auto-renew on an annualized basis. From the home navigation of Online Express, in the top left-hand corner of the page, I can click on the menu, at which point I select Fleet Solutions. At this point, I'm gonna select ClearSky Smart Fleet. This lands me on my fleet level data dashboard view. You'll see a variety of data widgets available, as well as quick access information such as how many connected assets are in our fleet, at this time, 150 assets. Making it highly customizable and actionable, the data is able to be dragged and dropped for a customizable dashboard. You can also save that dashboard underneath any name to return to it at a later date or time. By clicking on the gear in the top right-hand corner, you have the ability to add or remove data widgets, which will continue to be updated on a consistent basis. Additionally, in the top right-hand corner, you can click on the Customize button or tab. By clicking additional data widgets that are available, or by clicking the four tiles in the top right-hand corner, you can actually see a fully customizable view where you can shift data parameters around, save it, and come back with that solution in sight. Everything in the site, being highly customizable, is clickable as well. So if I were to click on any individual solution, such as machines with active DTCs, it's going to filter the entire site down to those two machines. I can also clear any DTC just by clicking any of the selectable filters at the top of the screen. Anywhere where there's an orange hyperlink, you can drive into more data-driven insights through a right pop-out. So if I were to click on more details, this is going to give me more information about those diagnostic trouble codes specifically. Additionally, I can click on fleet average age, where I can start to see more information about my fleet, and if I were to click on an individualized asset, I can dive deeper into that asset level insight. At this point, I'm going to click on fuel level, which we have 29 machines, and as you'll see, when I click on that, it actually shows of those 150 assets that we had, how many of them, from a percent basis, is this actually filtered to? And we can scroll up and down and see those individualized assets, including things like envelope profile, where in the bottom left-hand corner, you can even change this from the current 2-week or 14-day view to a 90-day view to understand how machines are used in those respective zones or those time periods. You can also look at interesting insights such as machine in use, ignition status, hardware reporting metrics, and battery information as we understand more about our connected fleets and battery state of charge information when it comes to electrified products. Last but not least, I do want to highlight any filter that you have. As you switch between tabs, there's a feature called persistent filtering, which will actually carry that feature to the adjacent pages as well. Now, similar to your dashboard view, the actual list view is very customizable as well. I can move my information around and easily adjust columns. I can also click on the three dots in the top right-hand corner, where I can add all additional data parameters that we have available. But all of this is about getting down to data-driven insights, at which point I'm going to click on the 1732 telehandler, which will give me a right bar pop-out where I can get basic information about that asset. In this case, that the machine is in an off state, the serial number, where it's physically located, and some attributes, in addition to things like quick links. At this time, I'm going to click on View Asset and drill down to Asset-Driven Insights. So now that we've landed on this 1732 telehandler asset page, a few quick pieces of information are readily available. First off, I can see this is a ClearSky Smart Fleet connected unit. If you are somebody who is using our legacy ClearSky solution, all of that data will be available in here as well and consolidated into one product offering. For this one, I can see not only what the serial number is, the make, PVC, and even things such as operating hours or software part numbers. I'm gonna click on the pencil edit item, which allows me, very similar to the mobile app, to apply an asset ID if I'd like to refer to something different from that of the serial number. In this case, I'm gonna say telehandler 1234. That's now updated across those respective solutions. Very similarly for quick links, part of being integrated into Online Express is now I'm deep linked to all these solutions. And what we mean by that is if I were to click on the pick list, it's actually gonna give me the pick list and build a material of that specific asset down to that serial number with all the available parts and picks available for it. Additionally, there's other information that can be actionable. So you can open up machine utilization to understand more about specifically how that machine has been used or is in use over either a 2-week or a 90-day timeframe. You also have the ability to see things like adaptive envelope. So where has that been used in its envelope zone? In this case, this is on a 24-hour view, but we could look at this over a 90-day cycle and see the various use of that end zone, assuming that that machine is equipped with that functionality. You can also see quick access information, such as where that machine is located, location temperature, and other information such as active DTCs, machine in use profiling, and historic trouble codes, in addition to other information that will be made available. Similar to your dashboard view, the actual asset page view is highly customizable using all those same settings toggles or customizing in the top right-hand corner. And this is where we will continue to add new feature functionality and actionable data. Another way of using this tool is obviously thinking about the machine location, at which point on the left-hand navigation, we've got the map view as well. I'm gonna click there now. As I click into map view, it's going to show me all of my machines that I've got available as far out zoomed as I am. As I continue to zoom in, you'll actually see that on the right-hand side, the right bar pop-out dynamically filters and shifts, highlighting only the machines that I'm viewing at this available time, and this will continue to change. Another important piece here is that you can actually filter to those visible machines, which will work persistently across the entire site. I can click in on an individual asset, and that's going to bring up additional information. Same things such as ignition on, serial number level information. We can also use that right bar pop-out by clicking details. This will allow me to get to that same asset view. You can also open up the chat, which leverages JLG's Online Express chat functionality. And you can also get directions to that asset, which will punch you out to your preferred map user and vendor within your respective portal selection. Now that we've finished looking at an individual asset within the map view, we want to talk about automated site numbers. Some of you might have used geofences before, very manual, it was a problem to be solved. We've automated that with our Bluetooth mesh network. As two or more machines start communicating to each other via Bluetooth, that will automatically form a site network to make you more effective from a branch location or job site management insight perspective. Now is a good time to mention that if you wanted to derive more insight from this information, it is both downloadable and exportable or shareable. Let's dive into that now. If you click on the list view in your left navigation, where we saw the table style format, using the three dots in the top right-hand corner, you can not only download this information to Excel, you can share it with individuals as well. Additionally, in the dashboard view, you have the ability using those same three dots to download this as a PDF, a PNG, or by clicking the share item, you have the opportunity to send that to individual emails or multiple emails, so those who are interacting with those machines have the ability to gain the same insights that you have through the portal. A lot of you have mixed fleets today, and in many cases, some of you have made the opportunity or investment to ingest data from the OEM into your in-house telematics solution. And I'm happy to say that ClearSky Smart Fleet offers an available API data feed today with 35 plus data parameters available to integrate into your solution, making it more actionable than ever. Our multi-layered data feed gives you more comprehensive data about the JLG product, including machine and operating hours down to the fractional level. In addition to that, you can also get unique machine status information, such as machine at height or load, as long as the machine has that available data to share. And how you choose to view this data is totally up to you. We can give it to you in a raw format, or if you'd like to, you can ingest this information into your in-house ERP system. We're willing to work with all. Using our straightforward integration guide, you'll have the ability to ingest this information on your entire JLG connected fleet in one comprehensive API feed and offer. Thank you again for joining us for this launch presentation and demonstration of ClearSky Smart Fleet, this all new revolutionary platform exclusively by JLG. We're hard at work developing new functionalities and capabilities, so make sure to check back often as we continue to enhance your fleet management experience.